Today we have a programming question, a very important one because it discusses the calisthenics consideration in particular. Thomas Rigny asks, what are the changes I would make in a straight arm movement, programming wise, relative to a bent arm movement? Let's first go over the definitions. A bent arm strength exercise is an exercise that you would perform body weight where you flex the elbows, okay? So they don't stay straight the whole movement, okay? In general, dips, push-ups, rows, pull-ups, handstand push-ups. Straight arm strength is a movement in general that you would keep your arm straight, front lever, planche, planche presses to handstands, planche to Maltese, and throughout the whole range of movement, or whether that being an isometric hold. There's a slight deviation from the strict definition of straight arm versus bent arm if the limiting factor of the movement is the actual straight arm component. Let me explain. In a straddle planche push-up, for anyone that ever did any planche push-up variation, they will know that the top third of the range of motion is the hard part, to actually lock the last bit of range of motion and keep the arm straight. This is the hardest portion. The two-third lower part of the range is the easy one, so the limiting factor is the straight arm component, hence it's a straight arm exercise. So that's the definition. The first training variable we will discuss is volume. Usually we will perform more volume in a straight arm skill relative to a bent arm skill. And the reason is, there are two reasons. That's first one would be that in a bent arm equivalent exercise, we will generally use more absolute weight. We've seen people perform dips with 100 kilograms on top of them. We've seen people perform chin-ups with 100 kilograms on top of them. We haven't seen people perform full planche push-ups with even 50 kilograms on top of them on the center of mass. So the absolute amount of weight is, the absolute intensity is higher in a bent arm movement. It is lower in a straight arm skill, so the amount of stress you can sustain would be higher. Second reason is, in a lot of straight arm skills, and especially if there's a transition to a handstand or something on the rings with a kip, and the learning curve is very gradual and steep. Relative to a bent arm exercise, where the learning curve will be much more sharp, and then it will simply sustain most of the technical efficiency improvement available from that point on. And since the technical component is so high, the amount of volume we need to practice in order to master the skill is much higher. The amount of volume we need to produce in order to actually be efficient neurologically within that pattern is higher. If you just perform 3 sets of 5 once a week, that's not enough practice. By the time I reach the next training session, I already forgot how I should false grip and then push and then where my scapulas. There are so many different cues that needs to be practiced continuously, whether that being with relatively lower intensities or higher intensity. The next training variable we will discuss is frequency. And in straight arm strength exercises, we will need, in general, higher frequency in comparison to the bent arm equivalent. We discussed about the learning curve. The learning curve is much gradual and long term than the most bent arm exercises, and especially barbell slow lifts. So we need to introduce higher frequencies. So anything above twice a week is what I usually prescribe to my students, and just to give them more learning time, learning exposure, different separate times within that week to be exposed to that movement. When we are learning, it's not simply the sheer amount of volume. Let's say 20 sets a week. It's the actual amount of time, amount of different times you are exposed to those, to that exercise. So if I perform those 20 sets in one training session, in compared to four different training sessions performing five sets on every one of them, that's four different learning opportunities. Four times a week frequency would be better to learn that straight arm skill in comparison to 20 sets within one session. So frequency will usually be higher. Don't forget that the blood supply to the passive tissues, so your joints, the ligaments, the tendons, is much more limited in comparison to the active tissues, that your muscles. So we need more, you need to pump the volume up, you need to pump the exposure through frequency in order to provide blood flow into the joints, because they are definitely stressed with those straight arm exercises, and we want to enhance their recovery, their adaptability. The last training variable we will discuss is intensity. And since we already went through the volume and frequency that needed to be upgraded, you should know by now that intensity will drop. If volume and frequency is up, or either one of them, intensity will probably drop on average. First and foremost, straight arm skills possess more risk of injury than bent arm skills. They stress the joints to a higher degree, and since most training injuries occur around the joint, not in the muscle belly, rather in the distal or the proximal end, the intensity would be lower, or should be lower. Going all out in a Maltese possesses more risk than going all out in a handstand push-up. And second, since volume needs to be high for us to address the technical aspect of the exercise, intensity should drop. If we perform 30 sets within a training week, including the specific warm-ups, let's say, we can perform on average all of those sets in 85% of our 100 reps or above. That would be insane. That will maybe show fast improvements to begin with, to the point that you will injure yourself or overtrain in some fashion. We need to drop that average intensity to around 70% of our 100 max, which is around what we can perform for 15 repetitions. We will wrap up the video after we discuss those three training variables. Really, coaching, teaching, programming the bent arm and straight arm skills is an art and needed to be mastered. You should deeply investigate this topic, or at least get a good coach and not make stupid decisions. That's what I think. And see you next question.